Buhimba Vocation and Technical Institute, located in Ibanda Village in Buhimba Sub-County, is one of the 15 technical institutions the government funded in efforts to promote skilling Uganda. Its two-phase development plan started in 2016. Chikube district leaders claim it has a land title covering 120 acres, which was offered to the institution by Hoima District Local Government. It was acquired in 2013 under the leadership of former local Council 5 Chairperson George Bagonza, but part of the land is occupied by 20 households with over 100 people claiming ownership.
We need this institution to grow. It has so many benefits, but we also have to appreciate and respect the rights of the people.
In the first phase, the institution structures were constructed on 6 acres of land, while the remaining piece of land was being utilized by the residents who claimed that they had lived on the land for the last 50 years.
They said now again they want to evict him again, because when they were evicted from this portion, they were referred to another one, but again the institute want to expand. So they are also fearing. But this time around they said no. Let's talk, because these people, many of them have been here for 30 years, 40 years, but of course they don't have a land title. And for us, we secured the land title for this institute in 2013, and it started operations in 2016.
When the skilling project was on, government asked the local governments who can avail land for the construction. And it so happened that by then it was Hoima District Local Government. It allocated the land and it is titled to a tune of 120 acres, but they never moved away the people on the land, the squatters. So the biggest challenge which I have with the second project is that where some of this construction is going to take place is being occupied by squatters.
The fresh wrangle comes after the government releasing 5.2 billion shillings for implementation of the second phase. District leaders have met with the claimants to resolve the dispute.
I'm going to write to the Minister of Education and informing them. They're already aware. The principal has been briefing them. They're already aware. What we are now requesting is to speed up the process so that we are not left, we don't lag behind. Because this is a government project, it has a time frame. The contractor is going to sign a contract. In April, he's supposed to even start work, but you can see he may not start work when there will be this kind of confusion. It's a big project, a 5.2 billion addition, in second phase.
Those who own the land, they should show evidence of that land. In law man's terms, it is either. How did you acquire that land? In our local terms, it is the endagano. To show that land is yours, show a copy of the endagano. Then next is for you to say what you have on that land.
Many of the residents are demanding compensation for properties lost in the first phase. Some claim they had permanent houses, farms, and even fruit plantations.
Omuntu mulingo kwa ikaile mukichiweka bagya kumuhereza ka conversation ko bwingiki kandi duration iki iba kumuhereza nuko nawa yetegule mubwire agende mu bwangu bamuhaire kurungi
ndi mwikazi wa hano hali tukali hano nkabanye na imusi yangiye mihoga
hallo ota
nkanyina huno umukeri hali mune nebitakuli hali mune nebichuwa beti yone babi hano.
Under phase 2 of the project, set to kick off in July, they will construct a girls' dormitory, 8 units for staff quarters, sick bay, a multi-purpose hall, and playground. This report was compiled by Ambrose Niwagaba for the news.